Well, this is definitely not the kind of grassland that I expected to see in Arizona. I mean, this is not short grass prairie. This is the famous Sacaton.
Giant Sacaton, Sporobolus reidii. Yeah, I like Sacaton. It's great habitat for javelina, western diamondback rattlesnakes, Botteri sparrow,
which is an uncommon sparrow.
Very uncommon.
Yeah. And this, what is special about this place? I mean, it's obviously in bottomlands.
Right. It likes to get its toes in the water. It does well here because the depth to groundwater is less than 15 feet.
And grass roots can go down a long ways.
Yeah, we've found Sacaton that goes down more than 20 feet.
Wow.
Those are some serious root systems for a grass. And one thing I'll mention about this place right here, last year, this all burned in a wildfire. So all the growth that you see here was from last year's not very generous monsoon, and then, of course, that subsurface moisture. Yeah. If we have a good monsoon year, this will be up 8 or 9 feet tall, even taller than it is right now. And back when the early explorers came through, they wrote about grass that was as tall as a man on horseback. This was probably it. But there is less than 5% of it left in its original range. It only is found in southwestern North America. And this stand here on the research ranch is arguably the best remaining stand in the United States.
This is a bedrock of this habitat for the wildlife here. And we really need to perk up and care about it. It's amazing, though, in this light.
Yes,
it is. Just an incredible patch of grass.